Warwick succeed Governor Olusegun Mimiko? That's a big question, I guess, considering the caliber of people who have come forward to indicate interest on the platform of the different political parties. INEC is yet to release officially the list of those who are eligible to contest in that race. Well, two lawyers are in a hot contest in the ruling People's Democratic Party with just a few days left before INEC releases the list of eligible candidates. There you have them on your screen. In the ruling PDP, all doesn't appear to be well considering the legal tussle that has thrown the candidature of Mr. Yetayo Jegede, the man said to be favored by the incumbent governor, Dr. Olusegun Mimiko, in the balance. As the court says, Mr. Jimoh Ibrahim, on the other hand, be enlisted by INEC. Two different primaries held, parallel primaries, one in Ibadan, the other one in Akure. But that decision by Justice Okunabang has been challenged in court by Mr. Jegede and his team. Meanwhile, Mr. Jegede was received by supporters and party faithful earlier in the week as a flag of his campaign. Both the governor and Mr. Jegede believes they will eventually have the day.
Number one, the significance is to drum home the point clearly that there is only one candidate for PDP, and that's Yetayo Jegede. Any other person is a pretender. Those who held their primaries in the Ibadan without the consent of security or INEC, those who know very well they cannot get through vote of the people and want to come through the back door, this is evidence that the door is already shut. Number two, we are just over a month of election. We think it's time to rule out. And you can see the joy and the enthusiasm of the people.
Officially, we are starting today because I just received the flag. We will continue to get our people to stay with us. We will continue to create the bond of friendship with the electorates. God willing, 26th of November, by the help of God, the support of the people who win the election.
Those thoughts of Mr. Yetayo Jegede and that of the governor of Ondo State, Olusegun Mimiko. Meanwhile, on the other hand here, Mr. Jimoh Ibrahim is very sure he is the authentic candidate of the PDP for the Ondo governorship election in Abuja earlier today. He spoke to journalists on how he hopes to win the race.
We have this judgment, which is now specific after submission by all the council. Is now specific to the extent that INEC, the first respondent alleged contaminant, shall accept and process for the purpose of his function and activities in organization the conduct of Ondo State governorship election, the nomination of Barrister Jimoh Ibrahim, who emerged from primary election conducted by first and second judgment creditor applicants on the 29th of August 2016 as a candidate of the said Ondo State governorship election slated for November 2016. So it's clear.
Well, that's Mr. Jimoh Ibrahim. On the other hand, who believes that with all that is on the ground and the judgment from Justice Okunabang is home and well to run for the race. Well, we find out what happens or what pans out when INEC eventually releases the official list of those who will contest in that race. Very interesting scenario playing out. In all other parties in the state, APC is not finding things easy, though, in their ranks. So they have a candidate in AD, where we have Mr. Olusoloke, who defected from the APC because of the crisis and the controversy over the primary. Is also not having things easy. Well, we'll keep tabs on how things pan out in the coming days. Well, let's move away from that to our major focus for the day. Since the raid on the homes of some judges in Nigeria, the message of Buhari government's anti-corruption war perhaps sent jitters to some nerves and caution to others. the question of the reasons and the manner in which the judges raided them were raised. The Nigerian Bar Association, on one hand, spoke loudly, and the Nigerian Judicial Council, the NJC, too, was not happy. But recently, the NJC appears to now be standing alone, as the NBA says the judges under investigation should step down from their duties until the cases are over and they are cleared. The NJC does not think that is the right thing to do. Let's take a look at what the NJC has said. It says that the position of the NBA, and I quote now, which is the 2014 revised judicial discipline regulations formulated by NJC pursuant to section 160 of the 1999 Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, as amended. Well, that's the NJC on one part. The group of senior advocates of Nigeria have also met, and they appear to be against what the NJC has said. Hear what they've said now, and I quote, in order to protect the sanctity and integrity of judicial processes that may involve the judges concerned and to safeguard the public image of the institution, the NBA had recently strongly recommend that, without prejudice to the innocence or otherwise of the judges involved in the ongoing investigations, they should be required to recuse themselves from further judicial functions or required to proceed on compulsory leave until their innocence is fully and completely established or until the conclusion of all judicial or disciplinary proceedings. That is what some of the senior advocates of Nigeria, that's their stand on this one. Well, a lot of people are speaking. The NJC, different group of people are speaking on this one. I put together some of the soundbite that you might find interesting in all of these debates. Take a listen now.